things, but sometimes we are limited. That is very, very important that we understand as parents. There is a time where things we cannot do, but there is one Father who is beyond all that. That's what is a nice theme for us to remember today. While I'm sharing this, yesterday I was speaking to my dad's immediate younger brother. He was terribly shaken because his daughter, who is a lawyer by profession, living a good life in Bangalore, suddenly things all turned around. She has problems with the kidney. She's on dialysis. She's just 45 years old. It's a terrible situation, very difficult for any father to bear. He was telling me, I'm here at 2 o'clock, and it was around 8 o'clock in the evening I called him, and I could hear in his voice how much of pain was there. I just want you to remember her in your prayers. All that I could tell him is, in a situation like this, we have no other place to go other than turn to God.
Amen.
Last couple of weeks, I was listening to a lot of YouTube videos. There's one person called Titus Thayappan. He's Italian. He served the Indian Air Force for a very long time. If you have not listened to this, I encourage, if you understand a little bit of Tamil, you should go and listen to this message. It's very apt with what I want to bring in today. The gentleman, for 58 years of his life, he served all kinds of gods and goddesses that he knew. He grew up in a very orthodox Hindu belt. And he believed that the god and goddesses that he served was capable of taking care of his needs. Everything was amazing and going excellent in his life. He had both his children getting their degrees, I think, in engineering. And his son doing amazingly well, goes to Singapore and gets a good job, and finally lands into the United States. Out of these 58 years of his life, when he traveled across the country, he built temples, he did everything that he could do, and he always thought that God's blessings was upon him. All the gods and goddesses that he served, that there was nothing lacking in his life. And he always believed that it was in return to what he did to his gods and goddesses. Suddenly there is a phone call from the United States, from the hospital, telling that your son is in a serious condition. He needs an immediate surgery and they want his permission. He said he could not believe it, and he was about to slam the phone and said, before he said, like, it's probably a wrong number, because my son is a healthy engineer working in the United States in one of the top multinational companies there. But before he could drop the phone, the person on the other side, are you Thayappan? Is your son Karthikeyan? It is him that we're talking about. He said, my whole world was shattered. 58 years I was holding on to a God. I considered him to be everything for me. He started asking questions, where are you now? In my situation where I'm terribly shattered. He says, is there a God that I've served? Why has this happened to me? Is it because of the jealousy of people around me? Is it because something that I failed to do? I've tried to do everything possible. Suddenly, everything comes to a halt. He comes to the United States. There's a picture of his son lying on the bed. He says, no father could look at that and be alive there. He said it was the most gruesome sight that he saw, his son lying on that. He kept on asking, all these years, what I've done, is it in vain? Was there any purpose? Is there a God who cares? Here I'm in a situation where I need help, and there is no one listening to me. He started crying, he started wailing, he started weeping. He started doing everything he could. And one day he was sitting like that, and I started crying and asking if there is a real God somewhere. If you claim to be the creator of this universe, if you claim that you created me, I'm asking you for help in this dire situation of my life. While sitting there, there's a gentleman walking by. He looks at him, turns back. Again, stops and looks at him and said, are you from India? He said, yes. Are you from which part of India? He said, I'm from the south. And he introduced himself as Pastor Jacob Cherian, or Jacob Thomas, I'm not too sure about the correct name. He stopped by. He said, he walked in. He said, what's your problem? He said, see, my son is in this condition. In less than a few minutes of conversation, he said, can I pray for your son? He said, I need all the prayers in this world. I'm in a helpless situation. And what I want to draw your attention to, something very important that this man said. He said, this man had met me for a couple of minutes. And in less than a minute or so, he started praying. He started praying as though he was seeing an invisible God right in front of him. as though he was holding on to his feet. He said he was shattered and praying. While this prayer was going on, one thought came into his mind. I want to draw your attention to that. He said, all these years that I've been praying, I've only prayed for my family. I've only prayed for my children. I've only prayed for my blessings. I've never ever learned to pray for someone else. And he's also asking this question. This man, I am the father. I know the pain and agony that I'm going through trying to pray for my son. But here is a man who stepped into this room few minutes before. How could he relate to my pain? How was he shattered so much? How could he take that pain and start crying as though he's his own son? He said, that is the time I realized it is only possible for a person who knows the living God and his love for others around him. He said, all my life that I have been worshiping, I've never ever learned to pray for my neighbor. I've never learned to pray for my enemies. Children of God, I want to remind you today that the true Father loves us.
Amen.
So that we might show that love for others. And that is what I want to encourage you today. Let us be reminded of this. And things turned around. It was an amazing delivery. He is a man of God today, praising and worshiping this true God. We are called for this purpose, so that we might transform this life to others.
Hallelujah.
There are millions of people around us, as I say, who need us, who need this hope and confidence in the only true Father. May God bless us. Before I finish, I just want to read this one verse, Psalms 91, the last two verses. It says, because he has set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. I will set him on high because he has known my name. It is very important that we know his name. He shall call upon me. There are times that we will have to call upon him. We have no other place to go to. And I will answer him. Please understand today that we have a God who can answer us. I will be with him in times of trouble. What a blessing. May God bless us.
Father.